So today we're going to talk about something that isn't necessarily Nintendo-based, but we're going to apply the potential effects of it to Nintendo because they are part of the gaming industry, and down the line this could be something that affects them. Now, this comes from Take-Two Interactive president Karl Slatoff, and he had this to say in regards to the future of video game delivery, and obviously had to touch a little bit on loot boxes, given that that is currently a ongoing issue that has starting to get legal repercussions. So let's just get into what he had to say. And he said this in an interview over at GameIndustry.biz. I think over the long term, it will be 100% digital, Take-Two Interactive president Karl Slatoff says. I can't predict whether it's 5 years, 10 years, or 20 years. It's probably less than 20 and maybe more than 5, but I think it ultimately gets there. That's the zeitgeist. Things are moving in that direction. And obviously here he's talking about how games are going to be delivered in the future, physical versus digital. Beyond that, he also goes into the loot box thing and how people are calling it gambling, as Take-Two has their own microtransactionness to some of their games, specifically with like WWE and NBA 2K, etc. And it says, the whole gambling regulator thing, we don't view that sort of thing as gambling. Our view of it is the same as the ESA statement for the most part. That's going to play its course. But in terms of the consumer and the noise you hear in the market right now, it's all about content. It's all about over-delivering on content and making sure you're focused on engagement. That has been our strategy and where we're focused. As long as you keep your eye on the ball, you're going to be okay. The consumer is going to be really happy with what they get. He added, you can't force the consumers to do anything. You try to do your best to create the best experience you possibly can to drive engagement, and driving engagement creates value in entertainment. That's how it's always been and how it always will be. Now, on his last point, he's not exactly wrong. If you're not engaging in the use of a product, if you're not enjoying your use of a product, you have a really, really low value of that product in your life. As an example, when I played Superman 64 back in the day, I was all excited for that game, and the engagement level of it was low. I stopped playing the game after an hour. I didn't get any enjoyment out of it. I felt like I wasted my money, and my entertainment value in that was extremely low. Of course, when you see words like driving engagement and creates value in entertainment, coming directly after talking about how things like loot boxes and microtransactions are not gambling, it's a very interesting stance because clearly that's not how it's always been. There hasn't always been microtransactions. There hasn't always been loot boxes. And that hasn't always been a driving factor for entertainment. Today, video game, you know, gaming has changed in this sense. In that before, it was all about here's an experience, here's a game. You play it until you complete it, and then you're done. Whereas today, it's all about keeping users engaged in your product over the long haul. So you play Grand Theft Auto 5, you get to the end of it, you've done everything in the game that you really feel like doing, and you just want to be done playing. Well, here's a multiplayer mode that just keeps you playing the game over and over again for years to come. And this is what's been happening with the advent of online multiplayer, is that people are using multiplayer aspects of games to keep players engaged for a longer period of time. Ironically enough, this hasn't actually led to games having a longer shelf life, which should be the point of it. To me, the point of video games, if you're going to extrapolate them into having a longer engagement session, is that those games should be on the shelf longer. As an example, Call of Duty with the multiplayer. Why is Call of Duty still coming out every year when you can engage your fans for years with a single game than releasing a brand new one every year? I never really understood why gaming is still trending towards releasing the games as fast as they can, but trying to engage users the entire time. Maybe it's just me, and maybe that's just, you know, a small sample size of games. But I want to extrapolate some of this into its effects on Nintendo, because this is obviously a big name. Take-Two, Rockstar, etc. They're basically almost, not quite all the way in on Switch, but they're definitely excited about Switch. They have some games coming to Switch or already released on Switch. Some quality games. I mean, even NBA 2K18, after it's been patched a bunch of times by now on Switch, is a quality experience. And it's something I would recommend to people who want to play NBA games, especially on the go. Now, the thing here is, we have a couple points to address. First off, it is the digital future. And that's what I'm going to focus this video primarily on, because it's hard to take anything Take-Two says about microtransactions and loot boxes seriously, because of course they're not going to view it as gambling, because that would hurt them as a company. So while I think what they're saying is completely asinine on that front, I don't think there's anything more to say than that. They make a ton of money off microtransactions. They're not going to say anything that negatively impacts that. So yeah, this is the expected response from them. It'd be weird for a company that makes so much money off microtransactions to turn around and be like, yeah, but they're a form of gambling. Because that just hurts them. So it is what it is. But that's what we're going to focus here on this first part, the digital future of video games. I think for a long time, a lot of people have been saying that video games are going to go all digital. And it's been an interesting prospect, because that hasn't exactly happened. In fact, we've seen, in certain cases, a reinvigoration of a physical product. Some of this is with those special editions, the Explorer's Edition for Breath of the Wild, pack-ins and all this stuff. But we've also seen, you know, like Nintendo. When you buy the Super Mario Odyssey bundle, the Switch bundle with the red Joy-Cons, you get a digital copy of the game. And they've been doing that with 3DS for a long time as well. It's been a very interesting prospect to see the growth in digital sales, and when digital sales are not only going to be more popular than physical sales, but eventually be the de facto way games are delivered, and that physical sales just don't exist anymore. And it's interesting to feel like that's going to be the future. And it's interesting because it's already the way it is on PC. It's been that way on PC forever. Most PCs you buy today, or build, or any enthusiast PC you see out there, they don't have disk drives anymore. We don't buy disks off a shelf and install them. And even if I went to Walmart and got a really, really good sale, let's say I was able to pick up Civilization VI for $10 at Walmart. I couldn't do that. I was actually looking for it on Black Friday for $10, but couldn't find it. But I could buy it at Walmart for $10. I don't even need to put those disks in my computer. I could just grab the code, register it on Steam, and download the game. So it's, even when you buy a physical medium, you could still use it as a digital one for PCs. This isn't the case on consoles yet. You know, you can't go buy a copy of Breath of the Wild physical and then download a digital version. It just doesn't work that way. So here's my stance on all of that. I feel like it is of extreme consumer benefit that we live in a digital future, in so much that the physical medium doesn't need to go away, but in so much that devices specifically cater to that type of future. As an example, and I'm going to bring up Nintendo in this because I want to tie Nintendo into this digital future. The Switch is not a device really built that well for a digital future. Not because it doesn't offer a cheap way to expand the memory. Of course it does. Micro SD cards, great decision. I'm glad Nintendo supports that. But because the system itself doesn't support the type of hard drive space necessary for an all-digital future. If you're going to have an all-digital future, the device itself needs to support such a notion. And while the Switch offers the right kind of ability to expand your storage, the base storage should be much larger. There is almost no reason there shouldn't be at least 128 gigabytes of internal storage on Switch, if not a heck of a lot more than that. But I feel like 128 would have been a nice sacrifice, considering the size of Nintendo games aren't necessarily as huge. But again, we're left in this conundrum where if you want to go all digital on Switch, you're going to have to buy micro SD cards, potentially several of them, in addition to your purchase. Whereas with like an Xbox One X, even I know 1 terabyte is still quite kind of small. You could still install around 10 games or so. Whereas with Switch, you might install one game and then that's it. Or in some games cases, you might not even have enough space on your internal memory to install that one game. So yeah, it's kind of just a big mess in my opinion. So what can we do about this? How can we fix this? What is the future of digital games? Why is the future of digital games? Obviously, until internet is available worldwide, physical games are going to exist. As long as people want to collect physical games, they're going to exist. I want to collect the entire physical library for Switch. But I'm going to tell you something right now, and this is something that I didn't really realize I didn't like until Switch. It's interesting because I've been PC gaming a long time. But on Switch, I really like the convenience of just selecting my game on the menu and playing the game. I don't like, especially since I do a lot of recording, a lot of local recording. My Switch is wall mounted, so I don't necessarily have the dock and the Switch right next to me. I always have to stand up and take the Switch out and take out the cartridge, change the cartridge. I have a little four cartridge holder here. I have five physical game cartridges for Switch right now. And they're big games. They're games that I want to play all the time. So I have to switch. I have to, you know, swap out the cartridges a lot. You know, let me just open this up here. I've got, you know, 1-2 Switch. You know, maybe that's the one I play the least of, but I really enjoy it. But I'm always switching out ARMS, Doom, Odyssey, and Zelda. I have to switch out those cartridges nonstop. And I'm going to tell you, because of that, I purposely play other games on the system a lot more. My Fire Emblem Warriors. I got Xenoblade Chronicles 2 coming up. I have a digital version of that. Snipper Clips and I'm trying to even remember my other digital games off the top of my head that I play all the time. Splatoon 2, that's another one. I'm constantly playing these digital games more because, not because I necessarily would if I had these games installed, but because it's convenient. There's a massive convenience factor to having games digitally, and there's always been a convenience factor, but it's never been more apparent to me than with this portable home console device where I'm playing home console quality games, and I could just not switch out cartridges to enjoy them. And there's always the fear. I have this inherent fear that when I'm on an airplane, when I get out my cartridges, that I'm going to drop one or several. Hopefully just one. And then if I drop one and it doesn't land on my lap and it goes all the way to the floor, it could get kicked around. It could end up somewhere where I lose it. These cartridges are small. And that's not, I mean, the cartridges should be small. That's fine. But it's just an inherent fear I have. Because I have, you know, I drop things sometimes. I think we all drop things sometimes. Maybe not game cartridges. I personally haven't dropped a game cartridge yet, just in my office, but on a plane, you know, some turbulence hits, something happens, in a car ride, on a bus, train, whatever. There's a lot of subway. I mean, there's a lot of ways that you might drop a physical cartridge. And you could say, well, don't change your physical cartridge out in the middle of a flight or in the middle of that. Okay, so now you're saying that you're just admitting it's more convenient for me to use digital games because then I don't have to switch out a cartridge. I don't have to be stuck to a single game the whole way. So I see the massive convenience in digital. I feel like, I don't know if in my lifetime, I figure I am 31 right now. I've probably got another 20 to 30 years of gaming left in me. Maybe another 50, 60 years of being alive left. And when I say gaming left to me, it doesn't mean I'm not going to play games when I'm old, but it means I understand that there's going to be a point in my life when I'm so old that my ability to game begins to degrade, to not be as viable as it once was, either it's because of my eyesight or because of arthritis or whatever ends up kicking my butt and makes me not a big gamer, you know, 30 years from now. But when I think about where gaming is heading, I think digital makes a lot of sense. I think physical is always going to exist in some form. It just might no longer be a primary method of delivery, which could mean, you know, places like GameStop don't exist anymore, or they all become like ThinkGeek stores, which are just gaming merchandise or nerd merchandise. Maybe they bring comics back or whatever the case may be. Not that comics ever went away, but you know what I mean. Start making it more mainstream again to have physical comics. And they still have games, but just not, you know, huge shelves full of them. I don't know, but I think that's kind of the future for GameStop if they want to stay viable. But it's just interesting to me to think about this all digital future, because I kind of want it. As much as I've always been an advocate for physical games, I'm slowly starting to come, I guess, to the dark side. And maybe it shouldn't be surprising considering that I'm also a PC gamer and it's all digital there, but it's so convenient. All we need now are devices that realize this convenience and give us the amount of storage that we really should have. Like PlayStation 4 Pro and the Xbox One X, they should come with like multiple terabytes worth of storage out the gate. So they're not even fully ready for this all digital future. The Switch should come with 128 to, if not 500 gigs worth of storage internally, but it doesn't. This is a future that until devices start offering that kind of storage, physical is still going to be highly viable. Why do I even have all these physical games? Because I don't want to keep buying SD cards. If I literally went straight digital on Switch, I would need to own multiple SD cards. Even if I had a 256 gigabyte card in there, or even a 400 gigabyte. Maybe I wouldn't have the 400 gigabyte full right now, but I would be over 300 gigabytes worth of installs if I had all of my physical games and all of my physical games as digital products. So it's a problem, and I realize it's a first world problem. Not all of you guys own as many Switch games as I do, right? You know, I own 16, 17 Switch games. A lot of you guys might only own one or two. So this isn't even, you know, a problem that's going to be there for everyone. But if we're going to hit that all digital future 5, 10, 20 years from now, it's going to start when products like PlayStations and Xboxes and Nintendo Switches start offering enough storage out the gate to support such a thing. Until that happens, despite all the expandability in the world out there, you know, the external hard drives you can hook up to Xbox One X's and stuff, it's not going to exactly be 100% viable until we reach that point. I don't know. You guys let me know what you think about a potential all-digital future in the comments below, and about 2K's comments on all this, and if you think they're right, if you think they're wrong. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe we're going to end up seeing a shift back to the physical medium. I don't know. You guys let me know what you think in the comments below. I am Nathaniel Ruffeljans from Nintendo Prime, and if you like this video, you know what to do. And if you dislike this video, hit that dislike button, subscribe for more content, and I'll catch you in the next one.